Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is disk differential. As you can see, disk differential looks like, a bit of a car differential, because when you move one gear forward and the other gear backward, the middle gear stays exactly put. And actually this one was inspired by a so-called torsion differential, or a limited slip differential, because when you when you just drive the differential like a car differential, where you put the power in the middle, then the two wheels, in this case the red and the green wheel, they will just follow. You push and the wheels follow, and if you go through a corner, then one wheel goes a bit faster than the other, or the other goes a bit faster than the one, etc. But the important thing about a limited slip differential is that when one wheel is not driven, because maybe you're stuck in mud and it slips, then when you push, the motor pushes the other wheel forward, suddenly the thing blocks. So it blocks and it can't go any further. And when the motor pushes, then it pushes both wheels with the same speed. And when the other wheel gets unstuck, then either when you're making a right turn or when you're making a left turn, it unstucks. And as I mentioned, this was inspired by the torsion differential, and I thought I can make this easier. So, or simpler, and let me show you how the inside. So here you have the inside. As you can see, this is much simpler than a torsion differential. Instead of all kinds of small helical gears, we have these thick spiral plates. And these can just be cast, like metal casting. You could make one spiral, and as you can see, the two of them are mirror images, so they are opposing each other. And what we have in the middle is this main gear with these little blue gears that are turning. And when I'm turning the green gear from this side, you see that all the little blue gears, they are either turning outward or turning inward. And when the red one is there, this is what does the making the differential. So I think that this really works, and I'm very curious about its practical applicabilities, and also whether there are reasons that you cannot use it. So let me ask you the question in a negative way. What would be a reason why you absolutely wouldn't want to have such differential in your car? Thank you for watching.